one's failure?
I have failed a lot, so I can I can relate to that. I would love to monetize them. It's a very tricky question, but do you have any answers? I mean, nothing really immediately comes to my mind.
I think I've heard this a number of times that every failure is to be seen more like a learning. But I came across this guy, Kalo Yankulov, who not only learned from the failure to start the next venture, but also monetized the previous failure in a very decent way. So Kalo wanted to launch a SaaS product, which was a marketing automation tool. And the reason Kalo wanted to do that was because his previous startups, by the way, he had done some 7 startups before he started this one. And all those 7 startups, he had faced failure. And he found that one of the massive reason why he was failing was around the effort that he had to put in around marketing. And there weren't easy marketing automation tools that at least he had seen. So that's what brought him the idea. But this time he was pretty sure that I need to, since I struggle in marketing, so I also need to get some pre-sales before I actually build anything. So what he did, he wrote about his last failure. In fact, when he was closing his last venture, he started writing about it in the blog, his own journey. And that journey, why he started, what were the reasons for his failure, etc., that brought in certain amount of visitors. In fact, to be precise, that brought in 3,000 page views. And through those 3,000 page views, he got some about 500 email leads. That's a smart thing which he did, by the way, that not only just put up a blog, but he also captured the email, which was about people who are interested in knowing more about his journey and what he's doing. Once he captured those 500 leads,
was he like building in public as to, you know, when he was going through this entire journey, was he like letting his entire audience know? Because
So I don't know whether that classical build in public method was adopted in his case or not, but what I understand is that he was writing a blog and that blog was getting traction, and this blog from his previous startup was focusing on that previous startup. At that point in time when he was writing this blog, he did not strategize it that from this blog I'm gonna get some sales for my next business. So he was writing the blog, he wrote a blog post which was kind of like the last blog post about the failure. That particular blog post got 3,000 views. From those 3,000 views, he collected 500 emails, which was a smart thing, that not only just leave it at views, but collect the emails of people who are interested in my journey. And once he had an idea about that next venture, which was a marketing automation tool, he emailed those 500 folks and gave them a lifetime deal that, hey guys, here is a deal for you. Now, that's the interesting part. These are the people who were reading about his journey. So they had some belief in him. They had not seen the product. They had a belief in him that this guy is a genuine guy. And that to me is like the key thing, that there was a connect between those folks who had given their email and Kalo. And through that connect, they believed that, okay, if this guy is building something which is based on his own failure, he would be building a decent product. And he priced it at about $89. Out of those 500 leads, 50 people bought that. So he had got $4,500 in pre-sales before he had written any single line of code. The only thing that he did was...
One more example of how do you actually charge before you build anything.
Absolutely. Actually,
that's so non-intuitive, right? As a builder, the first instinct is, let's make a product and see what happens.
Yes. So I think, so for me, one is, this is another example of getting the money before you actually put the effort of producing the product or the content or the course, etc. But the second thing, like I said, was the power of making a personal connect with people who you want to offer anything later. So this is like the next level part of building an audience, that people who gave his email, by the way, for me, these figures are obscenely high. 3,000 page views resulting in 500 email leads doesn't happen a lot. 500 email leads resulting in 50 people purchasing, again, doesn't happen a lot, at least to my limited understanding. The reason to me these things are very high is because these people were connected with Callo, because he had been documenting his own journey. And when he was documenting, there was absolutely no intention of selling later. It was very authentic journey.
Yeah, well, see, it's also, for example, when a startup ceases to exist, it already has created a certain amount of momentum. And those users would have read about, let's say, kind of his journey. And from there, they that build that element of trust, and then they go ahead and believe in whatever product that he creates now will at least address their pain points. Yep. It's always better, like in B2B products, rather than dealing with somebody unknown, it is always better to have a face behind a product.
Yeah.
Very, very interesting. Yeah.